When you could use a little help getting started with a CorelDRAW project, it's nice to start with a template. In this video, I'll demonstrate how to access and use CorelDRAW templates and how to save your own templates. Before we get started, if you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on Corel's Discovery Center. Here you can also find a written version of this tutorial. There are several ways to start a new document from a template. From the Welcome screen, you can open the Get Started tab and click New from Template, which opens the Create a New Document window and the Templates tab. Choosing File New from Template does the same thing, and choosing File New opens the same window where you can switch to the Templates tab. Corel subscribers can access the online library with over 200 design templates. All users also have a local collection of several pre-installed sampler templates. In the new online library, templates can be searched by name or keyword, and deleting the search term brings back the entire list. You can also sort by newly added, most recently used, or name. Choosing Recommended for You sorts templates according to your CorelDRAW subscriber profile. Your profile is based on survey questions about your proficiency level and the types of projects you work on. If you didn't fill out this survey or want to update your profile, open the Learn Docker to the Explore tab and click the Personalize Results icon. The online template library can also be filtered by category, such as infographics or brochures, and returning to all categories brings back the entire list. Template thumbnail size can be adjusted with the slider. When Show Template Details is checked, the right side of the window shows an enlarged version of the selected template, listing its title, size, orientation, pages, sides, and folds. Clicking Open does two things. It opens a new CorelDRAW file based on the selected template and also downloads the template. Returning to File, New from Template, the template I just opened has a downloaded icon, and toggling the Show Downloads Only icon shows all previously opened templates. Note that you can view properties of a downloaded template, but these properties cannot be changed. This is to prevent your edited template being overwritten if you download the template again. You can save a copy of a downloaded template locally and make any changes you like to the template itself or to its properties, as we'll see later in the video. Local templates include the pre-installed sampler templates, any templates you've opened from the online library, and any custom templates you saved to the Corel template folders. Local templates can also be searched by name or keyword, sorted by name, date created or date modified, and filtered by category. For a selected local template, clicking the Properties icon opens a window that also lists the template's tags, which are the keywords that can be used for searching. If you add or change tags, or change the title, be sure to click Save. There is also an icon to open the local folder that contains the template. Right-clicking the thumbnail of a local template opens a context menu in which you can mark a template as a favorite. You can see your favorite templates by filtering the list for favorites, and this menu also has an option for templates recently used. Non-subscribers can get more templates by clicking Get More. This opens the store, where a selection of templates is available for free and for purchase. Let's say I want to create a template for a company newsletter that I can edit and distribute each month. I'll start a new document from a template and search in the Brochures category in the Online Template Library. I'll select this newsletter template, and to open it, I can click Open or double-click its thumbnail. As mentioned earlier, this adds the template to my local templates. Now I'll use this template as a basis for my own company newsletter. I'll select this polygon and change its fill color, remove the generic company text, and import a logo image to use instead, and change this text. I could make similar changes to other pages of this document. Now I want to save this document locally as a new template. I'll choose File, Save as Template, and this is the default Local Template folder. Library Downloads contains the downloaded templates from the online library, and I'll place this file in Corel Templates where the other local templates are stored. I'll assign the name Ascent Newsletter and save. Because this is a local template, I can edit its properties. I'll change the template title and enter the tags Ascent and Monthly, separated by semicolons, to make it easy to find this template. This template is already in the Brochures category, but I could open the list and place it elsewhere or create a new category. I'll click Save again. Now I'll start a new document from a template, open my local templates, and the template I saved is in the Brochures category. I'll open the template, and each month I can edit the template. This particular template has power clip rectangles for images, so I can import an image and drag it into a power clip, holding the K key to replace power clip contents. After completing this monthly edition of the newsletter, I'll use File Save As to save in a different format, such as JPEG or CDR, so that I don't overwrite the template file. Any CorelDRAW file can be made into a template. In this example, I have a design that I want to use as a template for all of the company's product review sheets. I also want to share this template with other designers in the company. I'll choose File, Save as Template, but this time I'll save to another folder I set up on a company drive that colleagues can access. Now, when I start a new document from a template, I'll need to search in local templates and find the correct folder. I could do this by clicking the Options icon and choosing Open Folder Location, but I would have to do this each time I need this template. Or I could choose Browse, but this would make the new folder the default for opening templates, which I don't want in this case. The way to make this folder easily findable is to use the Choose Content Source option and choose Add New. I'll click Create Alias, browse to the folder, and select it. Now, for future documents, I can find this folder in the Choose Content Source dropdown, and returning to all folders brings back the entire list. The Browse Recursively option will search both folders and their subfolders. Reindex will scan the folders, look for any new or deleted files, and update the template window. Finally, whereas CorelDRAW files are saved with the CDR extension, template files have the extension CDRT. If I use File Open instead of New from Template and open a template file, I'll be asked whether I want to create a new document based on this template or open the template itself to edit it. This brings us to the end of this tutorial on templates in CorelDRAW. If you've been watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on Corel's Discovery Center. Here you can also find a written version of this tutorial.